we have come to rejoice in his name. God is good.
Yes, he is.
Not some of the time, but all the time.
All the time.
God is good. We woke up this morning. The star is on our way.
Yes.
And we're here to give praise and thanks for all the things that he's done for us.
Yes.
All that he's doing and all that he's going to do. As we come this morning, giving praise and thanks for a beautiful, lovely day, we were waking this morning with a little shower of rain.
Yeah.
And after the rain, what happens? The sun shines again.
Yeah.
And we're here to give praise and thanks.
Yeah.
Our meditation hour begins now as we give thanks to the Holy One for all the blessings that he continues to bless us for. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for blessing us, for keeping us, and for making a way for us when we see that there's no way. And we just give him praise and thanks. We'd like to welcome those of you that are present in the sanctuary this morning to give praise and thanks to our Holy God. And to those of you that are listening to this service this morning, we welcome you. We ask you to wake your neighbors, your friends, anyone that's around you that you can reach this morning. Let them know that Neil Fellowship Baptist Church is alive and doing well. We here to praise God on this given day. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you for your grace, and we thank you for your mercy. We thank you, dear God, that you saw fit to allow us to come again to your sanctuary to give you praise and honor and glory. We thank you, dear God, that you continue to watch over us. You continue to keep us, God, in your care. When things seem to be going astray, God, you are there. And as you promised in your word, you'll never leave us nor forsake us. We claim that promise right now because you are good, God. You are an everlasting God. You are merciful, God. You are kind, God. And you are patient. And we just ask you right now, God, to keep us encouraged. Keep us motivated. Keep us uplifted, God. Bless us all as we come in your sanctuary on today. Bless those that may be on their way, God. Give them mercy. Allow them to reach this place here without hurt harm or danger. And our pastor and his younger wife, vacation during this time, God, we just ask you to watch over them, cover them with your precious blood, keep them safe, allow them, God, to enjoy the R&R that they so deserve. And bless them all, God, as we continue to serve you, here and now, here and now, here and now. Bless the man who can bring the word to us today. Fill him with your Holy Spirit. Inspire him, dear God. Keep him up with us. This we pray in your precious name. We say amen, amen, and amen. We receive now our worship leader to worship with us on this day, our sister and trustee, Ellen Ellis. Give her a round of applause.
Good morning,
Pastor.
Good morning,
praise God. Hallelujah.
glory to God. Hallelujah this morning. Hallelujah. And we searched all over and couldn't find nobody. Hallelujah.
Searched all over. I couldn't find nobody. I looked high.
Thank you. God, we pray, God, that they remember to turn to you, God, the author and the finisher of their faith. have to remember the mothers of our church, God, Mother Black, God, Mother Davis, God. Continue to be with Deacon Black, God, and his family, God, Sister Black. Just bless them, God, for you know the needs that they stand in this day, God. Lord, we ask you to be with the one who stand in John's shoes today and declare the gospel to your people, God. Yeah. Open our ears and our hearts to receive what thus saith the Lord. Yeah. What you have given him, God, we just ask you to be with us, God. Lead us and guide us and keep us, God, and direct us. But we lift your name, God, because you are just so worthy, God. Yes. So, God, we just want to say thank you, God. Continue to be with us, God, for we will forever lift your name and give you all honor and all praise that you and only you deserve. For these things we ask right now, in the precious name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Miss Longshore, for last night. It's offering time, church. Proclamation time. We will be rendered with a sermonic selection coming from our Reverend Hendricks. After the sermonic selection, we receive Reverend Walter Longshore,
Amen.
Who will deliver what God has put on his heart to give to the people. In that order, please.
You belong.
Classic 3 since funeralized. Oh, yeah.
But I'm not going to discuss why this message has been placed on my heart. I'm just going to do my best with what God has given me.
Amen.
It's time. In discussing time, there are several ways of looking at it. There's a time of day such as 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. But is that where I'm going to go today? There's a time for certain sporting events, which means the 2 minute warning of 8 seconds left or 24 seconds. Deacon O'Dell knows what those are. I remember when I visited my wife before we were married, and I'd sit up there and we were talking and joking, and then she'd get up and say, "It's time." And I said, "Oh, okay, it's time." But I knew it was time for me to leave. She said,
"All right,
I knew
well.
Go home." But it was time for me to leave her house. And I protested. I said, "But it's time." So, like a future husband, I. But the time I want to talk about is the time of your life. Say the first verse, how you spent your time in the past, and how you spend your time now, and how you plan to spend your time in the future. My friends, there are many things that a man can control or think he can control, but he cannot control how much time you have on this earth. God is still in charge of our coming in and our going out. You know, we may have machines and new medications. The man says, "Oh, that'll make it like a little longer." God, remember, God is the one who gave us these new medications. God is the one who gave man the knowledge to build these machines. So it's God giving man a little credit for something that God has already done.
Yes.
What we are in charge of is how we spend that time.
Yeah.
That we have been blessed. I don't know how you spent yesterday or those years in the past. We cannot go back. We cannot change anything that happened in the past. May have been something that you said or something that you regret. You cannot go back and unsay it. If you broke a window, the window is still broken. You may be able to replace the glass, but whatever you damaged, it stayed damaged. You cannot undo it. You see, time is not constant. You cannot stop it, you cannot change it, you cannot speed it up. Time is constant. Only God can change time. All man can do is the best the time that God has given us. When we woke up this morning, it was the first day of the rest of our life. We need to spend it wisely. Because we do not know how many more we may have. I can give suggestions. But each person has his own ways. You see, my friends, the way we spend our current days may decide where we will spend eternity.
Yes.
Each day does not have to be fanatical. You don't have to run and pray and do everything. But just remember that you have to undo what has been done. We spend our days working, loving, sleeping, being with family, having fun, sometimes not having fun. We also spend time being angry, being hateful. We spend time hurting others, and sometimes being hurt by others. We spend time being sick, in prison, either physically or figuratively. Basically, my friends, we live life until we die. That is what we do with our allotted time. As the scripture says, there is a time for all things under the sun. But as we use the time allotted, we must also spend time with God.
Yeah.
We remember that He is one of a lot of our days. Some of us here are only for a short while, while others may live more than the speech more than said. But some of our time must be spent praising God. Thank Him for what He has given us.
Yes.
We also need to use our time to help others, to enjoy their time. God has given us talents to use. But these talents should be shared with others. Our talents come from God. Even if you work on them and you perfect them to make them better. Because remember, God is the one who gave you the talent in the first place. And the talent I lied to you.
Yes, sir.
You know, because only what you have done for God will last. You know, the big car and the big house will not be remembered. The bank account will be disturbed, and relatives will be running around buying their car. Other items take the course. But the fact that you taught children to help those who are less fortunate, always willing to lend a helping hand, those are the things that we remember. Future generations may not remember the name, but they will know, oh, I remember my grandmother saying that somebody helping her out when she was young or doing a favor. These are the things. I said they may not remember your name, but what you did to help others will always remain. And they will thank you as being the one who paved the way. They will know that you spent your time here on earth in order to make it a better place for your children and the descendants of those who came in contact with you. Media, I was thankful to have this opportunity this morning. In closing, I just want to remind each and every one to be mindful of the time you have been blessed with. Remember who has given you that time. No one knows when your time will end. But I will tell you, stay connected through prayer. Always have a kind word for your loved one. And you know, this is because you don't want your last verse to be with your loved one to be the last. Because you don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. So always, like you said, never go to bed angry. And even when you have an argument with a relative or a friend or a child, they said, yes, we are arguing. I don't like you, what you did, but I love you. And because you can never know. And you know, I have two more things, a couple things I want to say. God is in the blessing business.
Yeah.
This past week I had two cars in the shop. One of them I blew up on him down, exit two on the turnpike. But you know, God saw it through. God saw me through. You know, it wouldn't have been too long ago, I would have been trying to hitchhike home and trying to figure out what to do when the car would have been gone. But see, by believing and worshiping in God, God saw to it that I had a way. He made that way. And I'm thankful for that. We all had a car and the brakes broke on her, some kind of way. She made it home and we got her to the shop. Got it fixed. Thank you, God, for doing that. You know, everybody here probably has their own story. You know, sometimes you even forget, oh, something happened with it, and then God gave me more time. God had patience with me.
Yeah.
And our friends, there are times in life when something happens in your life that you just don't know how to deal. You don't know. You just did hindsight. And when this happens, all you can do is trust your God. When a man cannot help you, God can.
Yeah.
And God will.
Yeah.
When you do not understand something, give it to God.
Yeah.
Take your problems, take your concerns, take your hurts, take them to God.
Yeah.
Give them to God.
Yeah.
And then leave them there. But see, I know what my God can do.
Yeah.
You know what our God can do.
Yeah.
And He is a blessing God.
Yeah.
You know that when our prayers go on, everything in God's hands.
Amen.
Please stand.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I want to take this opportunity to open the doors of the fellowship at this church. If someone is out there on Facebook who do not have a church home, Nina is here. We are located at 174 South Valley.